Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video. Today we are flying again the 777-300ER service from London Heathrow over to Los Angeles. This is about a 12 and a half hour flight, but our exact flight time, let's see, it's gonna take a while, 10 hours and 31 minutes. And we've got 13 hours and 14 minutes of fuel on board. We are, as you can see, about 9 aways from departure, 9 minutes away from departure, meaning departure of the gate. And yeah, we pretty much got everything set up to go. We're just waiting on our load sheet, and then from there on we are ready to push. We've got some new things installed, actually, starting in this video. And that is Ultimate Ground Crew X, which I'll try and demonstrate a little bit. And Rex Skyforce 3D. I've got some textures installed from them, which I already think it looks quite nice. So I'm quite happy with that. Only thing I don't like right now, which has nothing to do with Rex Skyforce, I believe, is the shadowing. Because these guys don't have PBR, the shadowing is kind of off when you look at it.
Go ahead.
Yeah, okay. But yeah, other than that, it's quite nice. I have to say, there's some things that when you talk, the ground crew pick it up as talking to them. See, like in that case, I did not say what I'm supposed to say to contact them, but they still register as that. So it's kind of annoying when I sometimes speak like to my friends on Discord or whatever, and the Ultimate Ground Crew just like says go ahead, and this happens in the air too, which is
hi guys, here's
even
the
worse.
Load sheet for you. Have a safe flight.
Thanks. So yeah, I think Ultimate Ground Crew should not have any voice input at all in the air, because it sometimes happens and it's not realistic for one, and it's two, it's just not right. That's what I like about DSX, is as soon as it notices you're moving, it pretty much disables DSX and totally. Like as soon as you start moving, or as soon as the pushback is completed, GSX will recognize that and will say, alright, no more ground services for you. That's what Ultimate Ground Crew should do. As soon as you start moving, Ultimate Ground Crew, as soon as you start moving and have finished your pushback, Ultimate Ground Crew will say bye-bye. Alright, load sheet has come to us, so we'll go ahead and enter in our weights. Our reserves today, let's see here, 5.15, so 5.2 plus 7 is 12.2. Cosmetics will do 100, and everything else is good. Thrust limit, we are taking takeoff 1 with no flex, and takeoff flaps 15 today, and CG of 25. Noise abatement departure procedure 1, so acceleration 3000, thrust reduction 1500, and engine out also 1500. V1, we want 160, 167, and 173 is good to go. We'll check our progress, about 134 nautical miles until we reach our top of cruise of flight level 320, which is fine. 173, let's go ahead and enter that into our speed here, and we are good to go. I don't know if you guys can tell, but I do have a slight cold, so I do apologize if, I don't know, something were to happen, I sneeze or whatever. I'll try to suppress it, but we'll see. Alright. Let's start the APU. See what signs are on. Flight deck doors close and locks. You displays are set. I'm gonna go and set
Go ahead.
Legs on this guy. And, yeah. Put to ground.
Go ahead.
Please disconnect the GPU.
Roger, disconnecting the GPU.
That's the next annoying thing. If you're using FS to crew, Ultimate Ground Crew also interferes. Even though they say there's an integration part into it, in some of their FS to crews, it's not really there. I don't see where the integration is. So what I would suggest is that if you have Ultimate Ground Crew, how do I say this? One sec. Cockpit to ground.
Go ahead.
Captain, the GPU is disconnected.
Cockpit to ground.
Go ahead.
Please disconnect the air conditioning unit.
Roger. Disconnecting the air conditioning unit.
Alright. So what I would suggest Ultimate Ground Crew, or FS2 Crew, or whatever program to do, is if Ultimate Ground Crew integration is enabled, then either the FS2 crew, flight, cockpit to ground, voice commands
go ahead.
Are disabled, or ultimate ground crews
Captain,
are
the
disabled.
Air conditioning unit is disconnected.
I would suggest the ultimate ground crews to be disabled until your time runs to zero. As soon as your time runs to zero, you have to push back anyways, and that's when you use Ultimate Ground Crew. So then at that time, your FS2 crew cockpit to ground commands are disabled. Anyways, doesn't matter. I'm going to suggest that to him, and I'll see what he says, because that's kind of a smart idea, to be honest. Alright.
Go ahead.
Cockpit to ground.
Go ahead.
Can we pressurize the hydraulics?
Go ahead.
Roger, you are clear to pressurize the hydraulics.
All right, guys. Everyone seated. We're all buttoned up and ready to go in the back.
Thanks.
If you need anything, just let me know.
All right, doors are closed. And we'll verify that. Here. Also, go ahead and call pushback sequence, user-defined pushback. Before start procedure.
Are we clear to pressurize?
Yes.
Okay.
Ground to flight deck.
Go ahead.
Communication check, please, and confirm the brakes are set.
Communications are okay and brakes are set. Communications are okay and brakes are set.
I am ready for the checklist.
Give me 1 second. Communications are okay and brakes are set. I don't know if I already said it. 1 second.
Thanks.
Alright, well. Whatever. Cancel ICAS. Before start checklist.
Before start checklist. Flight deck door. Closed and locked. MCP.
V2173. Heading 272. Altitude 6,000.
Takeoff speeds.
V1160, VR167, V2173. V2173 set.
CDU preflight.
Completed.
Completed. Trim.
5.75 units, 0 and 0.
Go ahead.
0 and 0. Set and checked.
Taxi and takeoff briefing.
Completed.
Before start checklist complete.
Start sequence is 2 then 1.
Check.
Roger, facing northwest, release brakes.
Brakes are released. Didn't do that, did they? Brakes are released.
Roger, starting the push. You are clear behind, and you can start your engines at your discretion.
Start engine 2.
Starting 2. Oil pressure.
Start engine 1.
Starting 1. Oil pressure.
Pushback complete. Set parking brakes, please.
Brakes are set.
Roger.
What I would also suggest Ultimate Ground Crew and FS2 Crew do with integration is that if you use the hot mute and the, I don't know what HS is, but the hot mute is the most important one. If you use hot mute on FS2 Crew, it will also activate or deactivate on Ultimate Ground Crew X, so if you have hot mute disabled, Ultimate Ground Crew will pick up what you say. Without it.
Okay, the tow bar is disconnected and the equipment is clear. Thanks. Have a safe flight.
After start procedure. Flaps 15.
Flaps 15.
Before taxi checklist.
Before taxi checklist. Anti-ice. Auto. Recall. Checked. Flight controls.
Checked.
Ground equipment.
Clear.
Before taxi checklist complete.
Clear on the left.
Clear right.
So we are taxiing via Golf Foxtrot Bravo Hotel Alpha. But as we checked our modems, we've read that taxiway Bravo between Kilo and Lima is closed, it's under construction. And so we're going to turn away from it. Just gonna go on taxiway Alpha.
The cabin is ready. Cabin crew, take your seats.
So far, I think the clouds look really good with the Rex Skyforce clouds. So I can show you guys the settings. For takeoff, right before I end the video, what my graphic settings are and what my
go ahead.
Oh my god, Ultimate Ground Crew is so annoying.
Go ahead.
What? So what all my settings are and what I use, etc. want to warn you guys though, that the performance I'm getting here is pretty much the best performance I can get with any aircraft. The reason is because the PMDG-777 is probably the lightest plane besides the Majestic on frames. So if I were to fly that flaps with these settings and with traffic and everything, I would probably be at 20 or below. What am I at now? Probably mid-20s. Yeah, mid to low 20s. So I'd definitely be below 20 FPS with FSLAPS on this, in this configuration, which is why I did for FSLAPS. I pretty much always disable AI traffic, no matter where I am. What is that Stealth doing? Backtracking on the runway.
Go ahead.
That's what I mean. I'm doing a taxi, but Ultimate Ground Crew still recognizes that I want him to talk to me. And talking, I need to go to VH1. Doesn't make a difference in Ultimate Ground Crew, by the way. I have to change it from flight to VH1 or from VH1 to flight. Doesn't make a difference. Watch. Cockpit to ground.
Go ahead.
See. The Delta came from. Never mind. Yeah, is that Ken? Okay. Looks like it. Yep. Ken. Nice. Red plane. 777. Wow, that was a short landing. Like we're gonna be in somewhat of a waiting line, especially since traffic is also landing. A319 or 20 just disappeared. Before takeoff checklist.
Go ahead.
Before takeoff checklist. Before takeoff checklist complete.
go. It's... Runway entry procedure.
Check. Clear on the approach.
Clear on the left.
Clear right.
Okay, it literally was not on my radar. Before I entered the runway, I even checked. And I looked to the right, there was no plane. So he definitely appeared out of nowhere. It was probably that A319 or 20 that disappeared.
Go ahead.
All of a sudden.
Go ahead.
He was supposed to take off. Take off.
Check.
Of course.
Thrust set. Knots.
Check.
Positive rate.
Gear up.
400 feet. Climb.
Flaps 5.
Speed check, flaps 5.
Flaps 1.
Speed check, flaps 1.
Flaps up.
Speed check, flaps up.
Set flight level 320.
Flight level 320 set.
After takeoff checklist.
After takeoff checklist. After takeoff checklist complete.
We're got a huge cell here. Not a huge one. That is actually pretty huge. That we're definitely going to try and avoid. We pan out a little bit more, see what else we can, we'll need to avoid. Okay, yeah, there's quite a bit here, so we're going to... as soon as we reach here, which might be already above 10,000 feet, your mic might be cut out, but I'm definitely going to try to avoid this.
Go ahead.
See? That's what I mean. Stop it, Ultimate Ground Crew. Jesus. Okay, this storm zone is quite huge. So we're going to...
Flight level 100.
just clipping it. So I'm going to quickly show you I'm going to show you the settings when I'm not flying. It's much better.
Go ahead.
I'll show you guys in another video. But if you guys like this, like these settings, just so you know, I'll go ahead and showcase them. So, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. And I will see you in the next video, part 2, and then in Los Angeles. Until then, and... Yes.